Minnesota health officials say a recently updated model from the University of Minnesota projects 22,000 COVID-19 deaths in Minnesota over the coming year. But health officials downplayed the significance of that figure, which is about half of what the original model projected 2 weeks ago. They stressed that there's a high degree of uncertainty with a potential range of 9,000 to 36,000 deaths.
The model is one, we think, quite valuable tool in helping to understand the relative impacts of different levers, different impacts of trying to mitigate the health harms of this epidemic. But it's one among many variables, and we'll be looking at a lot of different factors and a lot of different considerations in addition to what the model suggests might be some of the impacts as we look further down the road.
A University of Washington model differs drastically with the U of M model. The Washington model projects just 456 Minnesota deaths through August 4th. Health officials say that model makes some incredibly optimistic assumptions and doesn't project deaths after 4 months, while the Minnesota model goes out a year and relies heavily on Minnesota-specific data. Now, the Minnesota Health Department reported 7 new deaths from COVID-19 today, raising the state's total to 57. 94 more people had tested positive, bringing the total number of confirmed cases to 1,336. In Lakeland Country, there are now 29 cases. Crow Wing County has 13 cases. Beltrami County has 5. Cass County has 3. There are 2 cases in Clearwater County and also in Itasca County. And Coochiching, Manoman, Polk County, and Roseau County, they each have 1 case. So far, there have been no deaths in this part of the state.
Lakeland News is member-supported content. Please consider supporting Lakeland News today.